Do you have a morbid sense of humor?
Why are your pants undone?
Do you enjoy laughing at others' expense? Then you'll love this show.
Hallelujah! Amen.
We've got a phony preacher who gets his plug pulled. Oh. There's a skateboarder who cements his legend. A D-list celebrity who gets effed up. A guy in a sumo suit goes on a roll. An ignoramus eats some greens and buys the farm. A video peeper takes a killer shot. And a TV huckster gets stuck on camera. Stick it all in the black hole of your soul and smoke it down.
You die, just like that.
It's the next episode of A Thousand Ways to Die.
Warning. The stories portrayed in this show are based on real deaths and are extremely graphic. Names have been changed to protect the identities of the deceased. Do not attempt to try any of the actions depicted. You will die.
Death is everywhere. Most of us try to avoid it, others can't get out of its way. Every day, we fight a new war against germs, toxins, injury, illness, and catastrophe. There's a lot of ways to wind up dead. The fact that we survive it all is a miracle. Because every day we live, we face a thousand ways to die. Do you like to watch all the home shopping channels? Would you like to meet the klutziest, most accident-prone salesman in all of television?
This is insanely useful. This will fit right... Oh.
That's him. If Chet was alone in a padded room, he'd find a way to hurt himself.
That is sharp.
It's a fully functional, different component system ladder.
A folding ladder seems like a pretty useful thing to have around the house.
And it's gonna be sturdy. You guys can really see.
In Chet's not-so-handy hands, the ladder was only a couple of steps from the emergency room.
I've seen plenty of accidents on set over my years. Some of the most common of them are just lights blowing out while you're talking on national TV, and all of a sudden, bang, the light blows out and you've got glass flying at you. I've had pictures fall off the wall behind me while I'm on TV, people getting cut with knives. There's lots of great stuff that happens.
We have authentic, traditional samurai swords.
Knowing what you now know about Chet, how do you think he did with a samurai sword?
That one looks extra sharp.
Oh, it really is.
Chet, are you okay? That looks painful.
Oh, that one got me.
Oh, that's gotta hurt.
A couple days in the hospital bed, and Chet was back in the studio smiling and selling.
This is one of the most fun products that we've ever had to sell right now.
His newest product seemed injury-proof.
This is called a Wonder Onesie. This is going to replace your pajamas. This is going to replace your sleepwear, your nightgown.
It would take a world-class klutz, a master of mishap, to hurt yourself with a pair of giant flannel pajamas.
But there's a little trap door back here. You never have to get out of this thing.
But our boy Chet always rose to the challenge.
If you order right now, you're going to get all these aromatherapy candles.
Oh, my God.
Bad to worse was Chet's middle name. After the brain-dead stagehand had no luck with a broken water extinguisher, Chet went up in flames.
Chet!
And came down burnt to a crisp.
When this person caught fire, the skin starts peeling away, the hair follicles start burning away, internal organs started failing, and the pain, shock, dehydration all combined into causing a painful death.
It's gonna be sturdy.
Chet was a nice enough guy. But he was his own worst enemy.
Oh, that one got me.
In the end, the only thing Chet had to fear
Oh my God.
Was fear himself.
Hillary became a minor celebrity after being voted off a now-forgotten reality TV show. Her 15 minutes are over, but she keeps chasing the spotlight.
Oh, you got the party.
Lately, she's hired a bodyguard and surrounds herself with a bunch of suck-ups who believe it when she tells them she's famous.
I got one from you, one from me.
To complete the picture, she snorts more cocaine than a Colombian drug lord.
I have this.
She even had her own platinum Coke straw.
When you have money and drugs and sex with beautiful people put in front of you, it's hard to say no. And when it gets to that point where nobody says no, that's when things become a problem. They keep spiraling and spiraling out of control.
There you go.
The former reality cast-off had completely lost touch with reality. She did anything...
What are you doing with my boyfriend?
And anyone she pleased.
Why are your pants undone? Hey, we're done here. Come in, get rid of this thing that's in my face. Get off me.
Hillary was good at pretending to be a star. When one of the party losers took her picture, she reacted as if it was a paparazzi attack.
Oh my God.
Look at me.
And like a true star, she called in her muscle.
Are you kidding me? Kevin, can you take care of this, please?
Give me the camera, boy.
Hey, get off!
Oh my God.
The 6-inch metal tube traveled up her nostril, blew through her septum, and lodged in her frontal lobe.
The straw, like a sword, punctured through that thin, bony wall of the posterior nasal passage, penetrating into the brainstem, causing immediate hemorrhage and damage to the central area of our brainstem that controls our heart and our lungs. And she died almost instantaneously.
Someone once said, fame is fleeting,
I have this.
But stupidity eternal.
Are you kidding me? Kevin!
Oh my God.
Enough said. Coming up, a preacher meets his maker. Whoa. Oh. And a peeper gets hammered.